So the idea of experimental history can be done by using two ways, students. The first one is additive rewards. The second one is discounted reward. What is additive reward is? So whenever the policy is executed, the environment will be state changing from the initial state to the final state. Okay. What is that utility value will be? It is just addition of all the rewards for each and every state the agent is visiting. Okay. So S0, S1, S2, so on. These are the states the agent is visiting. So what we do here, we just add the rewards of each and every state the agent is visiting. That is called additive reward. Like that, we are finding what is the utility value of environmental history. Okay. And what is discount reward here? The discount factor is introduced here. Okay, what is gamma here? Gamma is a discount factor that will be introduced, and gamma value is between 0 and 1. Okay, and based on this discount factor, the agent will be having the preferences between the current reward over the future reward. Okay, so that describes the preferences between the current reward and future reward. And this discount factor, if it is equal to 0, then what is the reward we are getting is insignificant. So this discount factor should not be equal to 0. Okay, if the discount factor is equal to 1, if the discount factor is equal to 1, we can see that discounted reward is similar to additive reward. Okay, so what is that we can say? We can say that additive reward is the special case of discount reward. Okay. Now, for example, if you take that the environment does not have the terminal states, okay, then the environment does not terminate at the terminal state. So that the what is that we'll be having? We'll be having infinite series, infinite environmental history. So what is the reward it is receiving is infinite. Okay. So, for example, if you have two sequences, both the sequences are having infinite reward, then how do you compare these two sequences? There are three solutions, students. The first one, we have to use discount reward. If you use discount reward, we can find the solution that will give you finite value. What is the finite value it will give is R max by 1 minus gamma. Another one is we have to assume that it is having the terminal state so that the environment will be terminating at any one of the terminal states. So if the policy that the agent is terminating at any one of the terminal state, then it is called proper policy. Proper policy, what it is, the policy it makes the agent to reach the terminal state. Proper policy is that the policy that makes the agent to reach the terminal state, that is called proper policy. For proper policy, we can use additive rewards. How do you write the utility function of environment history? Environment history can be represented by using additive reward in the case of proper policy. So in the case of improper policy, what is that? The environment will not be reaching the terminal state. It will be away from the terminal state. Okay. So in the case of improper policy, we have to use discounted reward only, because if you use additive reward, the whatever algorithms we use for solving MDP will fail. Okay. So that is why the utility function should be represented by using discounted reward only for improper policies. What is improper policy? Improper policy does not reach the terminal state. Okay. So another solution is that how do we compare infinite sequences? We compare infinite sequences by measuring what is the reward, average reward it is getting per time step. Okay. So for example, if the agent is receiving the average reward of 0.1, if this 1, 1. In other terminal states, it is non-terminal states, it is receiving a reward of 0.01. Okay. So in that case, the agent wants to stay in the state where it is receiving the maximum reward. Okay. So like that, we will be using the average reward it is receiving per time step we are using to measure the quality of two sequences. Okay. Now, how do you find out the value of policy? Okay, value of policy can be obtained by just applying expected utility of the discounted reward. This is the formula for discounted reward, students. If you just expand this equation, we get the equation of discounted reward. Here we have discussed, no? What is the equation of discounted reward? This is the equation. Okay, it's the same equation we will get. So, how do you measure the value of policy? Here is, we will be finding the expected value of discounted reward of each and every state the agent is visiting by applying this policy. Here we are just applying this policy. By applying this policy, agent will be moving from one state to the other state. Okay, so we have to write what is the discount reward of those states. Okay, find the expected value of discount reward obtained what are the states the agent is visiting by applying the policy. Okay, now what is the optimal policy? The optimal policy is that the policy which gives you the maximum expected utility. So, which gives us the maximum expected utility. By applying some policy, we are getting the maximum expected utility. That policy is called optimal policy. Okay, so this we have discussed in the last class.